Kia ora, I'm Jaden Randall and welcome to my channel. Just a little disclaimer before I start this video, I'm house sitting at the moment and I'm looking after two very cute dogs, so if you hear really random noises or if you even see them jump up here, sorry. I've been hearing a lot of ads on the radio lately about university open days, and it reminded me that this time 2 years ago, I was in the kind of situation where I was deciding what I wanted to study, where I wanted to study, and what I really wanted to do with my life. So today I thought that I could give you guys, I guess, a bit of tips and advice and kind of really just share my experiences with you and what I learned going through all of that. So before I start the video, I just want to say that in no way am I trying to push university onto you. I understand that uni is not for everyone, and that's 100% okay. I know that some people aren't even ready to go to uni, some people don't even want to go to uni, and honestly, that's fine. This is just to, give you guys a little bit of insight if it's something that you're thinking about. What I really want to highlight is that it's okay to not know what you want to study. When I was in my last year of high school, even actually studying at NCEA, so year 11, I felt a lot of pressure to know what I wanted to do because I felt as though I needed to select the right subjects in order to get into university, you know what I mean? Into the course that I wanted to do. All throughout high school, I kind of changed what I wanted to be when I grew up. Like, I wanted to be a physiotherapist, a journalist, a TV presenter, a teacher. Like, it was always changing because I didn't know what was out there. And then in year 13, I kind of realized that there's so much out there that I don't even know about yet. A lot of degrees have bridging courses, so if you don't have those credits in a specific subject, you do that bridging course, then by the end of it, you have everything you need to start on that degree. Sometimes at high school, we had like a careers expo, so there were loads and loads and loads of university stalls around our auditorium. There was just representatives from each university kind of talking to you about what they offer. So those are really helpful. As boring as it may sound, I think you should definitely go if university is somewhere you want to go. Another thing I would say is to go to the university open days. I think it's really important to plan open day visits. A lot of the open days are on the same day if they're in the same city, if that makes sense. So I'm pretty sure, don't quote me, that like Victoria and Massey University in Wellington are on the same day. That way you can come to Wellington for one day and then you can go to Victoria and Massey and you're not having to make two trips. They're either on the same day or one after the other, but you catch my drift. If you end up going to that university, when you get there the next year, you kind of are a little bit familiar with your surroundings and you feel a lot more comfortable, trust me. Scholarships. So once you've gone to all the open days and you think that you have an idea of what university you want to go to, I really, really, really highly recommend going and applying for scholarships. There are so many out there. Just do a little bit of research. For each university that you are thinking of going to, they will have lots of different scholarships available. So definitely research those, see which ones you're eligible for, and apply. Even if you're not 100% sure you're going to go to that uni, just apply anyway. If you get the scholarship and you're not going there, all you have to say is, no, sorry, I'm not going to that university, and they can give it to someone else. And don't cut yourself short. Apply for all scholarships that you can go for, that you are eligible for, because you never know what ones you might get. And every little bit counts. Okay, moving away from home. This is a hard one. Making the decision to move away from home, to choose a university that's really far from home, I say, do it. For me, I'm such a family girl and we're all kind of based in Waikato. So when I had to make the decision to move, it was really, really hard because I knew what I was leaving behind. And I know it can be really daunting and it can be really hard to make that decision, but just know that home will always be there. If you decide to move 6 hours away and you stick it out for a few weeks and you know what, you just don't like it there, you can always go home. And don't get me wrong, there are some days where you're going to feel homesick and you're going to want to go home. But just remember why you're there. Before I end the video, I just wanted to share what I study with you guys. I feel like my degree that I do isn't that well known. I mean, maybe it is, but I didn't know anything about it until someone told me about it. I don't know, maybe there's some people out there who are watching this who will be really interested in this degree, so yeah, I study at Massey University in Wellington. I study a Bachelor of Commercial Music. There are three majors that fall under that degree. There is practice, technology and industry. I major in music technology, so what that means is that it's kind of the behind the scenes, I guess. I'm learning a little bit about sound engineering, lighting, live mixing, a little bit of how to make your own music, interface, so that's software and hardware, lots and lots of different things. Something that's really cool about the music technology degree is that they let all sorts of skill levels into that course. Music practice, it's basically all things performance. You get to compose your own music and you learn a lot about composition. You get to perform in bands. At the end of your first year, you get put in a band, you get to compose all of these songs, and then you have a gig at the end of the year showcasing all of the songs you've written. There's also industry. That's where you learn a lot about the industry. So you learn about royalties, how to manage events, how to manage artists. I'm going to wrap up this video here. I hope this has provided you with a bit of useful and helpful information. If you have any questions, please feel free to comment down below or DM me on Instagram. It's right here, at Jaden Randall, and I'll be happy to answer any questions that you guys may have. I'm sorry if this was really vague. I just really wanted to talk about really key points. Just know that it will come to you and everything will be okay, and there's so much out there. And you know, if you make a decision to study something and you decide, well, you know what, this isn't for me, you can definitely change. There's no pressure and you're never tied down to one thing. Have a think about going to open days. Plan them out, make a trip out of it, take your family so they can kind of see where you may be studying as well. You got this, I can't wait to see what the future brings for all of you guys. Don't forget to like and subscribe and turn on the post notification bells so you don't miss an upload. Thanks for watching guys, see you when I see ya. Bye!